away, or?
No, they're all bills. I don't open them until I can pay them.
What happened?
I just dropped a pan.
Oh, dear. I believe somebody's done the do here.
Damn it, I forgot to buy more diapers. I am so stupid.
Okay, honey, let me just run out and get some, okay?
I'll be right back. You've done enough. It's...
What?
A mouse, and I keep calling the landlord and he won't do anything. No. I'm scared they're gonna bite him.
Stop it. I'm gonna get the baby. I want you to pack your bags. You're coming home. Yes, Mama, that is the exact box that I am talking about. I'll be by this afternoon to pick it up. Okay. Thanks, honey. Love you. Coming.
Hi, Mrs. Sims. Is Kelly here?
Hey, big man.
Kelly's not here. She's working. Remember, she has a job.
May I?
You have a lot of nerve showing up on my doorstep.
Kelly won't call me back. I just left the apartment. Is everything okay?
No. Everything is not okay. Kelly and Emmett are staying with us for a while.
Why?
Why? You ask? Because Kelly is a single mother working a double shift so she can make ends meet alone. Because her husband won't get a job. Because her husband won't step up to the plate and be a man. Because her husband is an immature jackass. And you are so lucky Colliar Sims isn't home right now.
Mrs. Sims, I have been trying to help her, but she won't let me. She barely lets me see the baby.
Don't dare look to me for sympathy.
Look, I just want you to understand that I would do anything for my family.
How about getting a job? Did you call the pharmacy? Did you ask for your old job back? Ajoni, when are you going to learn to sacrifice? You've got to learn to sacrifice.
Can I take Emmett home with me?
Did you ask Kelly?
No.
Phone's on the table.
Bye, little bear. Daddy loves you. And I'll see you soon, okay?
Hey, you almost ready?
I think so.
This is gonna be so cool. I bet we have a huge turnout. I'd like to see Mr. Tucker not hire women after this.
Don't you think the diner would be a lot busier on a Sunday afternoon, like right after church?
Yeah, but I already passed out posters that say Saturday.
I know, but I was just...
Grandma Otis told everybody at the NOW meeting last night. I mean, why do you want to change it? You're not trying to back out on me, are you, Rene?
No, I really want to do this with you, but...
But what?
I have a meeting with the Black Student Union at 2 o'clock
on Saturday.
I'm one of the speakers. You know I've been planning for the Democratic Convention in Chicago. The NAACP wants to work with us. This is a huge deal, Emmy.
And my little boycott isn't a huge deal?
Of course it is, but I made a commitment to the BAC.
You made a commitment to me.
Emmy, I'll come over as soon as I'm done. I know how important this is to you.
Do you? After all the years of going to your rallies and your marches, this is finally something that we can do together, united as women. What happened to our sisterhood?
You and I are sisters. But let's face it, even if B's Diner starts hiring women, they will never hire blacks, except as janitors.
Oh, so your cause is more important than
mine? No, but I am a black woman, and I will always be black first.
Why aren't you a woman first?
Because that's not how people see me.
Well, that's how I see you. But I guess that doesn't matter.
Jamal wanted me to thank you again for taking on the case.
He should thank himself. He stuck to his guns, got lucky with a fair judge, and ended up with a verdict which reflected what he was willing to do in the first place, put his hair up in a ponytail.
I still say it was all you.
Did you and Jamal go out to celebrate?
No, not yet, but we will.
We might want to hold off on that celebration.
Hey, Jamal.
What's the matter?
I just quit.
What?
I know. I go to court and force them to hire me back, and I'm there for a few hours, and I just quit.
What happened?
They passed out these letters as soon as I got there.
They're implementing random drug testing for all employees.
I'm surprised it took them this long to come up with that one.
Wait a minute. They can't just target you like that. Rene, can they get away with that?
I'm afraid they can.
But I don't understand.
Yeah, Lakeisha, we proved our point. And now it's on the record books forever. I just hope you don't think I wasted your time, Rene.
Freedom is always worth fighting for.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Well, ladies, you know the rules. No eye rolling, no sabotaging, no interrupting. You have the floor.
Go ahead, Millie.
Fine.
So, you gave me a budget of 50. Here's what I can do for 30. Ms. Renee Jackson and Mr. Clyde Terhune cordially invite you to attend the wedding of the season. Let me just set the scene for you. It's a black tie affair, an elegant evening wedding. The 200 guests have taken their seats. Unity candles light the sanctuary. I can get them at below cost. And a beautiful white wedding arch waits patiently at the end of the aisle. When the big moment arrives, your bridesmaids, who will look stunning in shimmering black dresses made of this material, will float down the aisle. Then the bride makes her appearance, a vision in the dress of her choice, which I would be more than happy to advise her on. The happy couple exchanges their vows, and the guests ring them farewell with these little keepsake wedding bells engraved with the words, "Ring this tiny wedding bell to wish the happy couple well." And it's off to the reception in a white limo, where a six-tier cake awaits, each tier a different flavor, surrounded by edible pearls.
Wow. Mildred, that was wonderful. Thank you very much. Emmy?
Well, I think when ideas come from the heart, you don't have to put on a big dog and pony show to impress people, you know? Kind of like putting perfume on a...
Emmy?
Okay. It's sunset. Everybody looks great. As the people come up to the church, they're greeted by a collage of photos, including this one, that has a quote underneath that says, "I want to stay here, marry a smart, handsome man, and have four children." The bridesmaids will be dressed in burgundy, just like this.
Oh, my goodness, honey. Where'd you find this?
Someone's mother remembered a 17-year-old girl's promise to put her bridesmaids in just that color.
Mama kept this all these years?
We got about 100 candles. Enough to light the place, but not enough to set you on fire. And right before you say, "I do," we play a little song by one of your favorite singers.
Aunt Kiki!
Didn't you always say you wanted her to sing at your wedding? And then you have a little something old to put in your shoe for good luck.
Oh, honey, one of our pennies.
I kept it.
We had jars of these in Fort Dixie.
You remember how you said run up and put them on the rail?
It's amazing we weren't run over by trains.
That's true. Remember that.
Wow, Mom, I can't believe you're going to plan Renee's wedding.
Neither can I.
Careful what you wish for.
You know,
I promised I would have this done by 8. I'm on my last paragraph. If you all could just please pretend that I'm not even in the room for about 20 minutes. I know that I could get through this.
Hey, no problem. Do you think you should?
Oh, I'll get it.
What are you doing here?
Can I come in?
Come on in, Ajoni. What are you doing here?
Well, first of all, I want to take Emmett for a few days. I really miss him, and I know you could use the break.
Fine.
Did you get the check I sent you?
You mean the one that barely covered the baby food?
Yeah, I got it. Did you get a job?
Not yet. I was thinking. Since I've been staying at my parents' house, and now you've been staying here, maybe we could save some money if we...
You wanna give up the apartment?
Well, it's just not that we can really afford it anymore. We don't even use it.
Fine.
Look, if you want to keep it...
No. We'll get rid of it.
Come on, big man. Come on. Come on. Let's go home. Let's go home. Well, good night.
Hi, baby. I'll see you soon.
I'll call you.